isinala nga natin ang office of the Vice President dito, tapos ngayon nagbibigay ng courtesy sa office of the President. Double standard dito. Nade-deprive ang mga mamamayang Pilipino na malaman paano ginastos ng Presidente, pinakamataas na opisyal sa Pilipinas, ang kanyang pondo. Nakakabahala ito dahil maraming tanong ang taong bayan. Isa na rito ang pagtaas ng unprogrammed appropriations.
At yun sana yung gusto nating matanong para masagot ng Office of the President. Why is it that from July 2022 to June 2024, Mr. Chair, ang dami pa rin violations, 42,000 victims ng forced evacuation, 105 victims ng extrajudicial killings, 75 victims ng frustrated EJK, 145 victims ng illegal arrest and detention, 63,000 victims ng indiscriminate firing, 44,000 victim ng bombings, and 3,400,000 victims of threat, harassment, and intimidation, Mr. Chair. Also, Mr. Chair, mas mabilis yung rate ngayon ng mga nagiging biktima ng enforced disappearances, yung mga desaparecidos under the current administration kesa sa former administration, Mr. Chair. So if we did not grant parliamentary courtesy, supposedly, hindi masasandal ng ganito yung mga pinadala ng Office of the President, Mr. Chair.
Object, in recognition of his distinguished role and significance in government, I move that we terminate the budget hearing of the Office of the President.
Is there a second to the motion?
Mr. Chair, let me explain the objection. I object, Mr. Chair.
Yes.
Objection.
Yes.
Mr. Chair, I object dahil sabi po ng Presidente, all government agencies undergo the same process during budget deliberations bilang sagot sa Office of the Vice President, Mr. Chair. So kung ganun, Mr. Chair, na ita-terminate natin ngayon yung deliberations, we are affirming ang pagiging brat ng Vice President. And in fact, Mr. Chair, pinapalabas natin na nagsisinungaling yung mismong Presidente by evading the process of Congress na mag-undergo ng scrutiny, Mr. Chair.
Take back your statement na nagsisinungaling yung Presidente.
No, siya, Mr. Chair, that would depend on the decision of this committee. Kasi on the record yun, Mr. Chair, sinabi yun ng Presidente, Mr. Chair.
Mr. Chairman,
yes.
I move that we delete the statement nagsisinungaling ang Presidente. That's very unparliamentary. So move, Mr.
I did not say that, Mr. Chair. I said
okay. Order,
that would
please.
Depend
order.
On the actions of order. This committee, Mr. Chair.
Yeah, but we have to delete that portion where you're insinuating that there will be pagsisinungaling if we follow tradition. No, because everything that is tackled in this committee and everything in the House is voted upon by the majority. So whatever the majority rules on does not mean that there is pagsisinungaling. It is just the will of the majority by which a democracy performs. Okay? So since you have an objection, we will now divide the House.
Yeah. Mr. Chairman, there are two pending motions. So we are tackling the first motion, just to be clear.
Point of order, Mr. Chair.
Yeah, one motion at a time. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
The first motion is the motion of the Vice Chair, Congresswoman Ching Bernos, to extend the parliamentary courtesy and terminate the briefing of the budget of the Office of the President. All those in favor, please raise your hands. Please have a hand count. 48 are in favor of the motion. How many are against the motion? 48 are against and 48 are in favor and 3 are against. The motion is carried. The budget of the Office of the President is hereby.
Point of order, Mr. Chair.
Yes, what is the point of order?
Yes, Mr. Chair. Mr. Chair, Section 104, Questions of Privilege, Mr. Chair. Questions of privilege are urgent matters directly and indirectly and principally affecting the duties, conduct, rights, privileges, dignity, integrity, or reputation of the House of its members, individually or collectively, subject to 10-minute rule, every member has the right to raise a question of personal or collective privilege, Mr. Chair. Gusto po naming makapagsalita, gusto po naming makapagtanong mula sa Makabayan Block dahil meron po kaming mga krusyal na tanong kaugnay dito, like the foreign policy, like the Kibuloy issue, like the unprogrammed appropriations issues, Mr. Chair. So, Mr. Chair, pwede po bang mag-ruling kayo doon muna, Mr. Chair?
Yes, the Chair will rule on the point of order. No? According to Section 105, the definition is correct. But this is not the proper venue to raise a question of privilege. The proper venue to raise a point of privilege is the plenary. So, Congressman Brosas, you can raise your question of privilege this afternoon at 3 p.m. at the plenary.
Mr. Chair,
that is the ruling of the chair.
Mr. Chairman, I have a pending motion.
Mr. Chair, I'm appealing.
Point of order, Mr. Chair.
Wait,
I have a pending motion that should be ruled.
Hold on. So the chair has ruled on the point of order.
Yes, Mr. Chair. I am appealing, Mr. Chair, kasi sinasabi po natin na kailangan sa plenary. But Mr. Chair, ang rules naman natin ay for all, Mr. Chair. So we are appealing from the Makabayan Block na makapagsalita po at makapagtanong.
Point of order, Mr. Chair.
I have
a pending motion.
She has the floor. We will let her finish, then I will recognize Congressman Jarin. So we will let Congressman Brosas finish.
Yes, Mr. Chair. I am appealing to the chair, Mr. Chair. Now, baguhin naman na magkaroon no, ng mga questions dito sa Office of the President, Mr. Chair. Gusto pong malaman ng taong bayan yung mga tanong na ito. Gusto po namin makapagsalita dito, Mr. Chair. So, Mr. Chair, can you rule on this also, Mr. Chair?
Okay. As previously ruled by the Chair, the proper forum for the question of privilege is the plenary. So I would like to recommend to the Honorable Arlene Brosas that if there is a question of privilege, to raise it this afternoon at 3 p.m.
Mr. Chair, so the appeal...
That is the ruling of the chair, and that is the ruling on the appeal.
Mr. Chair, anyway, the appeal is subject for voting, Mr. Chair.
No... The Congressman Brosas, wait, there is a pending motion. Now that that I have ruled on your point of order, I will go back first to the pending motion of Congresswoman.
Mr. Chair.
Yeah, Mr. Chairman, allow
hold
me
on,
to
hold
reiterate.
On.
Okay, Mr. Chair.
Sandali po. Sandali po.
Kasi kayo, kanina Mr. Chair, you have you asked for the votes
Opa.
Noong mga nag-approve,
Opa.
Terminate the, Opa. Ano no, and we object. Can you give us time to explain our vote why we object, Mr. Chair?
Teka po, sandali lang po. I will recognize first Congressman Garin and then we will get back to you. Yes, Congresswoman Garin.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chair. Allow me to reiterate my prior motion that the statement of the Honorable Raul Manuel, specifically the terms pagsisinungaling, be deleted from the records.
There is a motion. Is there any
object,
second
Mr. Chair? And allow me to explain my objection. Again, kung babalikan natin yung
point
records,
of order,
Mr. Chair,
I have
claim.
A pending motion.
Wait. Okay. Hold on po. So there is a pending motion. Is there any second to the motion? Is there any objection? Okay. Now we will divide the House. Secretary, please count.
First, Mr. Chair, allow me to explain your objection
point
before we
order,
proceed
Mr.
to
the chair.
Mr.
Chair, we need to divide
even
the House.
Plenary,
we are not in the
we
plenary.
We count the votes first, okay? Sige po. Please raise the hands of those in favor of the motion. 51 are in favor of the motion, and please count those who are against. 3 are against. The motion is carried.
And now, Mr. Chair, allow me to explain why I voted no. Then again, Mr. Chair, the statement that I quoted comes directly from the President. Na-quote po yan sa media. And Mr. Chair, the actions of this committee will determine kung totoo ba yung sinabi ng Presidente o hindi, Mr. Chair. Again, we want all agencies to undergo the fair process. So supposedly naman, kung aprubahan din naman eventually yung budget, then dapat masagot lang po yung mga tanong, Mr. Chair.
Point of order. Mr. Chair,
wait,
we have already decided that is Mutan Academy.
Hold on. Let us let Congressman Manuel proceed.
Yes, Mr. Chair. Kasi nga, hanggang ngayon, nag-exist pa rin yung National Task Force ELCA, which has already been the target, Mr. Chair, of
point
calls
of order,
for abolishment,
Chair.
Mr. Chair. Pero isa ito sa mga grave questions na dapat sana na pag-uusapan natin.
It's not an issue that's being discussed now, Mr. Chair.
Yun yung mga issues na gusto nating matanong, Mr. Chair. But
point of order, Mr. Chair. The Honorable Manuel is discussing matters. Point of order, Mr. Chair. He's out of order. We're not discussing NTF-ELCA here. There was a motion that we terminate the budget briefing of the Office of the President. Duly seconded, objected, voted upon. I therefore move, Mr. Chair, that we go back to what is the agenda of this House that has been terminated, duly seconded. I therefore move that we suspend consideration of the budget until 1:30 this afternoon.
Suspended.
Mr. Chairman, with due courtesy to the Honorable Manuel, because I believe they would like to have a manifestation, allow me to withdraw my motion to suspend the budget briefing, and it's until 1:30. So therefore, I withdraw that motion, Mr. Chair, to allow the quick manifestation of the Honorable Manuel.
Yes, but before I allow the Honorable Manuel to make a quick manifestation, again, I will state that the statement of the Honorable Manuel, wherein he said something like the actions of the committee will reflect on the President, does not follow, because we are a co-equal branch of government and the President cannot dictate on this committee or in each congressman the wills of each congressman. And whatever happened here today is the will of the majority. So I just want to clarify that. Yes, Honorable Manuel has 2 minutes to make a manifestation.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Nandiyan ang Office of the President to supposedly set the tone regarding the protection of the rights of people. And when we say rights, kasama po dyan yung economic rights ng taong bayan, commitments para taasan yung sahod na ating mga manggagawa, and of course, civil and political rights. Mr. Chair, while the current administration seeks to distinguish itself, no, na hindi na daw ira ng kadiliman sa ngayon, pero Mr. Chair, the actual experiences of the Filipino people say otherwise. At yun sana yung gusto nating matanong para masagot ng Office of the President. Why is it that from July 2022 to June 2024, Mr. Chair, ang dami pa rin violations, 42,000 victims ng forced evacuation, 105 victims ng extrajudicial killings, 75 victims ng frustrated EJK, 145 victims ng illegal arrest and detention, 63,000 victims ng indiscriminate firing, 44,000 victims ng bombings, and 3,400,000 victims of threat, harassment, and intimidation, Mr. Chair. Also, Mr. Chair, mas mabilis yung rate ngayon ng mga nagiging biktima ng enforced disappearances, yung mga desaparecidos under the current administration kesa sa former administration, Mr. Chair. So if we did not grant parliamentary courtesy, supposedly, hindi masasandal ng ganito yung mga pinadala ng Office of the President, Mr. Chair. Kaya naman, once again, all of these, alam natin, coordinated po yan ng National Task Force LCAP, of which yung chair mismo ay ang presidente. At contrary sa sinasabing na-achieve na ng NTF-LCAC yung goals niya, Mr. Chair, nagdadag pa ng mga member agencies, namely CHED, DOST, tsaka Department of Migrant Workers, Mr. Chair. Kaya naman, hopefully, ito yung mga hinahanap ng taong bayan natin. Bakit ganito pa rin hanggang ngayon? Nasaan po ang pagbabago? At ito ang popondohan natin through the 2025 National Budget, Mr. Chair. Yun lang po. Salamat.
Thank you very much, Congressman Manuel. Congressman Rosas, will you make a manifestation?
Yes, Mr. Chair. Mr. Chair, sabi ko nga kanina, we have crucial questions about the foreign policy. Mr. Chair, very concerning po yung pagdikit ng gobyerno sa US sa kabila ng tumitinding girian sa West Philippine Sea. Yung pagdami ng EDCA bases, balikatan exercises, war-provoking missile systems sa Ilocos Norte, tapos yung Agreement for Cooperation in Peaceful Uses of Nuclear Energy o 123 Agreement. Parang ready sa gyera ang gobyerno o nang-uupa. Mr. Chair, gusto rin naming matanong, will the government go after those who aided Kibuloy? Kasi kung matatandaan, sabi ni former President Duterte, alam daw niya kung nasaan si Kibuloy, pero secret lang daw. Si VP Sara Duterte, sabi niya, nasa langit daw. Obstruction of justice ito. Third, Mr. Chair, isinala nga natin ang office of the Vice President dito, tapos ngayon nagbibigay ng courtesy sa office of the President. Double standard dito. Nade-deprive ang mga mamamayang Pilipino na malaman paano ginastos ng presidente, pinakamataas na opisyal sa Pilipinas, ang kanyang pondo. Nakakabahala ito dahil maraming tanong ang taong bayan. Isa na rito ang pagtaas ng unprogrammed appropriations. Noong 2023, nakita ang pagtaas ng i-allocate na pondo sa unprogrammed appropriations mula sa 2023 NEP na 588 billion naging 807 billion sa 2023 GAA. At 332 billion dito ay napondohan. Sa 2024 NEP, bigla na lamang lumaki ang UA mula 2024 NEP na 281 billion naging 731 billion sa 2024 GAA. 160 billion 68 billion dito ay napopondohan na mula January to July 2024. The amount generated for the UA under Marcos Jr. in 2023 was equivalent to the total UA generated during the 5 years of former President Duterte. Dinagdag din ang GOCC excess funds bilang isa sa mga magpupuno ng UA. In-expand ang mode ng UA, unang beses ito ginawa. Actually, wala ito sa 2024 NEP version. Dinagdag lamang sa Bicameral Conference Committee. Maharlika 2.0 ba ito? Sa 2024 UA provision, sinasabi na may top priority na paglalaanan ng unprogrammed funds. Pero nakalagay din sa UA provision na pwedeng i-modify ang order ng priority. Ibig sabihin, pwedeng unahin pondohan nang makokolekta sa UA ang infrastruktura, depende kung anong sabihin ng presidente. Imbes na nasa regular item, dapat personal benefits at ang budget para sa public health emergency benefits and allowances para sa healthcare at non-healthcare workers, nilagay ito sa UA. Kung ganon, nasa discretion ng presidente kung saan ilalagay ang pondo sa ilalim ng UA. Pwedeng manipulahin ang program at unprogrammed funds para magkaroon ng dagdag na source. Pork or presidential pork feet po ito. I've said this before and I will say this again. This is about transparency and accountability. The Office of the President or every other agency is not exempted. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Yes, thank you very much for the manifestation, Congresswoman Brosas. Next would be Congresswoman Castro. Would you make a manifestation?
Yes, thank you, Mr. Chair. So, nag-object tayo sa naging proseso, no? So, ginawa natin sa lahat ng agency na nag-interpellate tayo, kahit na sa Office of the Vice President noong August 27 na ipinakita natin yung ating, no, yung ating mandato na dapat i-scrutinize, busisiin ang budget ng lahat ng ahensya, walang exemption kahit na Office of the President pa yan. Isa dapat sa mga itatanong natin, Madam, Mr. Chair, ay yung papalobong intelligence funds and confidential funds. So mapapansin natin, Mr. Chair, sa 10 billion na budget ng Office of the President, halos kalahati dito ay nasa CF at saka intelligence fund. So 4.56 billion. Okay, nagsimula ito, no, Mr. Chair, sa para sa history, nagsimula ito ng 2013, yung pagbibigay ng 2012, yung pagbibigay ng CF tsaka IF. Pero nung panahon ni Duterte, President Duterte, lumaki ito, naging ano, no, naging nung 2017, 1.25 yung CF at saka 1.25 din yung confidential funds. Hanggang nung 2020, 2.25 yung IF at saka nung 2020 po ay 2.25 din yung CF. Ngayon, pinagpapatuloy po ng Administrasyong Marcos itong paglalaan ng confidential funds. Ginaya po, no? Napakalaki doon sa panahon ni President Duterte. So, hindi po ito dapat dahil hindi naman po ito yung ano, no? Yung trabaho, mandato ng ating presidente or Office of the President. Last September 14, 2020, during the budget hearing of the Office of the President for the fiscal year 2021, Deputy ES for Internal Audit Bernardo said that the CIF of the OP was used on the following: Presidential Situation Room, National Anti-Money Laundering and Counter-Financing, National Cybersecurity Interagency Committee, Presidential Anti-Organized Crime, Philippine Center Anti-Terrorism Council and National Coast Watch, etc. So kung titignan naman po natin, no, ito naman, wala naman po ditong national security na involved. Nasasabihin lang yung mga activities, programs na pinanggamitan noong CIF. Kaya pwedeng-pwede po, no, matanong at masagot natin, meron bang mga naidagdag na mga activities dito na pwedeng malaman ng ating taong bayan, no? At tingin naman po natin, ito, sinasabi natin na kino-question natin yung 125 million na confidential funds na ibinigay natin doon sa Office of the Vice President. Pero gusto ko rin sana questionin, bakit pinayagan ito ng OP that time? So, yun lang po naman yung gusto nating tanungin. At itong ano, no, yung latest, Mr. Chair, kaugnay doon sa ill-gotten wealth ng pamilya ng Marcos, may decision na kasi ang Supreme Court no? At natalo ang pamilyang Marcos dito sa bid sa Pawai Complex. Ano nang gagawin ng ating pangulo? This is a Supreme Court decision. So ano ba yung maipapaliwanag niya sa ating mga kababayan kaugnay nito, no? More than ano, no? Sinasabi dito sa decision, Mr. Chair, yung laki ng ano, no? 576,787 square meters na inari nung panahon ng dating Pangulo Ferdinand Marcos Sr. na dapat na maibalik dahil ito ay public land. Kaya ano na po yung magiging ano na magiging decision ng ating Pangulo kaugnay nito. So yun lang po, Mr. Chair, wala namang ano, no? Wala namang masama kung mag-interpellate tayo dahil ito ay may kinalaman sa ating ano, no? Sa ating budget pa rin, Mr. Chair. Thank you.
Yes, thank you.
Mr. Chair.
Yes, before I recognize our Senior Vice Chair Stella Kimbo, the manifestations of Congressman Manuel, Congresswoman Brosas, and Congresswoman Castro are well taken. We thank you very much for your manifestations in order for the Office of the President to prepare the reply so that we can explain it fully during the plenary sessions. Thank you very much, Bob. Yes, Senior Vice Chair Stella.
Yes, Mr. Chair. Maikling manifestation lang po. Paglilinaw lang po sa ating mga kababayan na maaaring nanonood ngayon. Ngayong maga po, wala pa pong approval na nangyayari po sa budget ng ating OP. Tayo naman po ay nakikinig lamang. And meron pa pong isa pang pagkakataon, yung pong plenary debates na mag-umpisa pa po sa September 16. At rest assured po na lahat po ng mga katanungan ay meron pa pong isa pang pagkakataon, which is during the plenary debates. At napakahusay naman ang ating budget sponsor, of course, the Honorable Toby Tiangco, at siya po ang haharap po sa inyo at sasagutin po lahat yan. And of course, ang ating kagalang-galang na Executive Secretary, Sir Lucas Versamin, at kasama ang buong team ay babalik po dito sa plenaryo. So, salamat po, Mr. Chair.